Hello, class 10 students. Today we are going to continue our discussion in regards to the peasant revolts. In the last discussion, we discussed about the peasants' revolts of Phulaguri, which are starting in 1861. Today we will continue with the peasant revolt of Lower Assam. Here, the peasants has got a theme of fighting against the British government through rice men, and after learning from the peasants' revolt of Phulaguri in 1861, they had started to organize their rice mill nicely, and they had got a decision, and they organized themselves through the rice mill, and they declared that those peasants who will oppose the decisions of the rice mill, as decided by the village panchayat or village sarpanch or the leader of the rice mill, they will be socially ostracized. Socially ostracization means that means that person, that villager who will not comply with the decisions of the villagers or the rice men, then they will be exiled from their own villages. It may be mentioned here that this revolt was not only against the British government, but also it was against the people who were invited by the British and further exploiting the very inhabitants of the Assam, like the Marwari Mahajans, the bureaucrats who came to Assam and started to exploiting the Assamese subjects by lending money and by mortgaging their lands against financial loan. So, as the peasants' revolt of Rangia, which was started on 24th December 1893, there the villagers in and around the Rangia, from various villages, they came to Rangia Bazar and start destroying, vandalizing the shops, houses of Rangia huts, and also they looted the mortgage papers, which of the peasants from the interesting mortgaging Marwari Mahajans. So the peasants felt that the presence of the Marwari had led to the increase in land revenue. The government had to send an armed force to control it. Here, in that connection, the police superintendent Riley was sent to control. There, the peasants were so very well organized, police superintendent Riley could not control the mail, or could not control the riots that has been started. And he could not muster the courage to arrest any of the peasants' leaders, because the protesters were very well organized. So again, on 8 January 1894, the police arrested 15 peasants who had come to discuss, who had come to a mail, rice mail, to discuss about how they will place their problem to the authorities, problems of their miseries to the deputy commissioners. So there, after the arrest of 15 peasants, about 3,000 peasants again from various modas gathered in front of the Rangia police station, where deputy commissioner Mac Cabe ordered them to leave. They refused to budge. They didn't went back. By evening, the peasants began to move closer to the police station, hoping that the deputy commissioner might give some notice regarding reduction of the land revenue. The only theme of the peasants that started the revolt was for the reduction of the land revenue. But there, deputy commissioner did not show any interest, and they also the peasants also began to demand the release of the associations who had been arrested by the police. When deputy commissioner asked for a peasants representative to discuss about the issues, the peasants shouted in a chorus that they will not pay the revenue at the increased rate, and the peasants then tried to forcefully enter the police station. Ultimately, Matt Cabe was helpless, and he ordered the police to open fire, which compelled the peasants to retreat. On 10th January, McCabe ordered through a notification that henceforth no public meeting will be allowed to be held without the permission of the deputy commissioner. That means whenever the peasants wanted to start any mail or public meeting assembly, then the peasants had to take permission from the deputy commissioner, otherwise they will not be allowed to do that. So The deputy commissioner then selected some leaders from the prison and appointed them as police constable. There was a planning of the deputy commissioner that whenever the leaders from among the prisons would be appointed as a police constable, and they will help for the realization of the taxes, revenue taxes, for collection of the revenue from the prisons, and these people will be able to convince the prisons for the payment of the taxes, and thereby deputy commissioner to that extent was successful. At that time, about 90,000 rupees has to be collected by the government, and thereby the government was able to collect about 60,000 rupees at the first installment, where the peasants were paying the British government. Even then, the repressive policy of the British could not stop the peasants from holding public meeting. And this way, whatever it is, this peasants' revolt of Rangia was not successful. Ultimately, the peasants had to pay the taxes to the British government. But the peasants' government did not hold their repression. They go on. In this way, public peasants in Nalbari, Barama, Bajali, etc. continued to be as active as earlier and did their best to set up all hurdles in the government in revenue collection. So, they were continuing their fighting against the revenue collection, huge revenue collection. In this way, as the peasants' revolt of Rangia was suppressed by the British government, the peasant revolt of Lachima also started at that time. Okay, the severe repression of the peasants' revolt of Rangia by the British government could not stop it from spreading to other regions. In this way, the peasants of the other regions were inspired from the ongoing peasants' revolt of Lachima, and also they were inspired by the peasant revolt which had started in 1861, which was the first peasant revolt. There, various people in and around the Bajali region comprising Lachima, Chowkhuti, Panagaon, Sathebari, Patakuchi, many names are there. Thousands of peasants participated in rice mill. The largest rice mill in this entire region was held in Panagaon Sapori. In this assembly, peasants from various places like Rangia, Nalbari, Dharam, Dharmapur, Bajali, etc. of North Karmic took part. So, an event occurred. Why we call as peasant revolt of Lachima? That these peasants came together and they decided among themselves not to pay taxes to the tax to the British government. Thereby, Dasuram Chaudhuri, he was the Mozadar of Kapla village near Lachima in Sarukhetri Moza, and his Mondal Holiram Mishra went out to collect revenue. And when they went out to collect revenue, they were badly beaten by the peasants, by the local peasants. So after some days, the Mozadar died. Dasuram Chaudhuri died. It was a criminal event. So getting the information, the circle officer of Borpeta, Madhav Chandra Bordoloi, arrested 75 people and took them to his rest camp in Lachima in connection with the beating and killing of the Mozadar and the Mondal. Here, Mozadar means it is a section of the revenue. It is a local name which is given for the revenue sections. A person cannot collect tax from one place as a whole. So, several person has to be appointed for collecting the taxes. So, these divisions of the revenue areas is called as Moza. And that person who is the head of the Moza, who used to collect the revenue and pay to the government, is called as Mozadar. So, there are assistants of the Mozadar, which we call as Mondal. So, the circle officer, when he arrested 75 people and took them to his rest camp in Lachima, after that, about 3,000 people surrounded the rest camp and threatened to burn it down. That is threatened, these 3,000 peasants surrounded the rest camp and they threatened to burn the rest camp. Thereby, the circle officer was compelled to release the arrested person. And again, next day, the deputy commissioner McCabe arrived here with about 30 policemen and soldiers from the Gorkha regiment and arrested about 59 rebel peasants and locked them in a temporary jail. So again, the same thing happened, same event happened. At first, 3,000 peasants came, compelled to release this 75%, and the circle officer was compelled to release these people. But this time, when 6,000 people signed a document demanding the result of the imprisoned prison, whom the deputy commissioner arrested 59 rebel peasants, McCabe showed no sympathy. Instead, by applying force, he chased away the crowd. Among those arrested were made leaders like those leaders who were arrested, like the leaders of the village, like Gosai Dole. These people were tied to plowshare. Plowshare means that means when two bullocks share one bridge for pulling the plow while cultivating the land. So it is called as plowshare. So two peoples are tied to this plowshare and they were pulling this plowshare like bullocks and paraded before the people as a lesson. And when people saw about this kind of punishment, the British anticipated that the people will not raise their voice against the British government so that no one may revolt in the future. 16 people were given various kinds of punishment for committing the crime of organizing the peasants revolt in Lachima and assaulting Holiram Mishra Mandal. Later on, the order of Calcutta High Court, the punishment sentenced for these people were reduced. 2 years of rigorous imprisonment was awarded to Pusparam Kalita, Devi Datta Charma, Jayanti Bes, Nirbhasa Kalita and Mongolo Kalita for organizing the leading the revolt. So in this way, the peasant revolt of Lachima also was suppressed and it came to a complete halt in this area. But still, the revolt continued to linger on. And in this way, the peasants' revolt of Patharughat was at its peak when the peasants of Kalaigaon, Mongaldoi, Sipajhar, they were conducting rice mill, and they were deciding that in the Patharughat circle, they will organize a big rice mill against the British government for not paying the taxes. And this news traveled from the tehsildar to the area of to the circle officer of that area. And again, the circle officer informed the deputy commissioner. In those times, the deputy commissioner was J.D. Anderson. About this proposed rice mill, in order to stop this huge public assembly, J.D. Anderson, along with a force comprising of police and military personnel and the police superintendent J.R. Bennington, arrived in Patharughat. Till then, in 27th January, the rice mill was started. With the help of the police and military, the properties of those peasants who refused to pay the taxes were confiscated. The properties were taken out, those peasants who refused to pay the taxes. And this infuriated the peasants, and about 200 of them surrounded Bennington, who had gone for the revenue extraction. He somehow managed to save himself from the clutches of the public and reaching the rest camp, describing everything to the deputy commissioner. The Barrington could not master the courage for controlling the peasants, and the peasant chased away Barrington, and to save his life he escaped from the scene, and he came to the deputy commissioner rest camp, and he narrated all the events what happened to him. A few hours later, around 2,000 peasants marched towards the rest camp. Almost each one of them was armed with sticks. This time, the peasants were infuriated. When the peasants reached the van camp, Anderson advised them to go home as soon as possible. Deputy Commissioner Anderson advised to go home as soon as possible. But they did not move. At this, the Deputy Commissioner ordered the police superintendent to disperse the peasants by using force, if necessary. Following up this order, police superintendent tried to forcefully chase away the peasants, but these peasants retaliated by brandishing their sticks, hurling stones, pebbles, and moved in closer. The raining of stone was so much they were unable to open their eyes, such that police, military, administrative officers, none could keep their eyes open. So under such condition, the deputy commissioner was compelled to open fire, compelled to give the order to the superintendent police to open fire upon this innocent peasants. And finally, in this open firing, according to unofficial record, about 140 peasants were killed and 150 peasants were injured as a result of the firing. But the British government were expert enough to conceal the original value, original figure. So on the other hand, the official record showed 15 killed and 37 injured. In this way, the peasants' revolt of Patharughat was also crushed by the British imperialism with an iron hand. On account of participating in this revolt, according to official sources, 37 peasants were arrested and tried. The circular officer of Mangaloy, Mr. Ransom, settled this case. Aklu Sheikh and six others were punished and the rest were all released. The peasants' revolt of the 19th century in Assam were no doubt successfully subjugated by the British government, but the series of revolt that began from 1861 were a great source of inspiration for the Assamese common people. Later, where the freedom struggle started. In this way, the people of India and also Assam had got a lesson that in this way, by mass struggle, by through extremists or being radical against the British government, it is impossible to expel the British government. So they needed a separate kind of, a different kind of organization to form to compel the British government. So in this way, the political organization has come into being, which has been initiated by Surendranath Banerjee, Umesh Chandra Banerjee, Allan Octavian Holmes in this way. So these things you have already studied, and the work of these kinds of organization you have studied in the previous two chapters. So these were the events that occurred in the form of peasant revolt in Assam. But the British could not control their greed enough to get more power to earn more revenue. So in this way, the British government started to extend their tentacles to the other part of the country, Ahom Kingdom, like the hilly areas, hilly to the tribal area. In this way, the people, hilly tribes, also struggle a lot against the British government, fighting against the British government, starting their ethnic tribal revolt. In the last discussion of this chapter, we will discuss about the ethnic tribal revolts, and after this discussion, we will discuss about the answers that has been given in the exercises in page number 57 and 58. First, we'll go through the short answer type question. I will provide you the answers through the video discussion, and then we will continue with the long answer type question. I hope so you will understand, and if you don't understand, you go on continue. And I want to request you that to share these videos as much as possible to your classmates. Thank you.